We've had a lot of requests on how to paint the camo cloak of the Eliminators from the Shadow Spear box set. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is a nice neutral colour for this particular colour scheme. Now, we're going to start by layering the entire cloak with Storm Vermin Fur. We're then going to start picking out some camo patches. Well, the first colour we'll use is Mechanica Standard Grey. We'll then follow that with Dawnstone. Once that's all done, we're then going to shade the camo cloak using Agrax Earthshade. We'll finish off with a highlight of Dawnstone. So first of all, I'm going to use my medium base brush. I'm going to get some Storm Vermin Fur dolloped onto my palette like so. A little touch of water as well, just so it flows a bit easier on the cloak. And then we'll start applying it. So what we've got here is the cloak itself. So I'm just going to layer over the entire cloak. You'll also notice I've not glued the backpack on. It just makes it easier to get in there, especially when you're doing those patterns. And I recommend probably doing a couple of coats of this as well. With the cloak now layered, we're going to be using Mechanica Standard Grey to start picking out the camo patterns. We're going for more geometric shapes with this, so none of the natural kind of organic shapes you tend to see on camo cloaks. They don't have to be squares or triangles, just go for hard edge kind of shapes and do several across the back of the cloak. And if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Storm Vermin Fur. With that first pattern now done, we're going to move on to the second colour, which is Dawnstone, to start picking out the next part of the pattern. And again, making those geometric shapes, we're actually going to start layering over some of the others as well. This will give it more of a camo kind of pattern feel to it. Should you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with those previous colours you've used. With those camo patterns now done, we're going to be using Agrax Earthshade. We're going to shade all over the cloak. But in the deeper recesses, we'll just pull a little bit more in there. And if it does start to pull a lot at the bottom, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Once the shade's dry, we're going to go back to using Dawnstone. For this, we're just going to pick out all the edges and folds of the cloth. So just take your time and use a nice fine brush. I've got a small layer brush here for this. With the highlight now done, the camo cloak of the Eliminator is finished. Well, I hope you found that video useful. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.